Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, today is the start of March Madness. The first game starts today on Thursday. And hopefully by now you've sent in your entry for the NCAA pool. This is where my job as a commissioner becomes very, very easy because basically as the games finish, I just need to go through and enter the team that won in each game and formulas in the rest of the worksheet total up how many games each person has won, but more importantly, how many games the person has lost. For example, let's say that your team to win the entire bracket would happen to be upset today. Well, we already know that you've lost that game in round 2, round 3, round 4, round 5, and round 6. There's 120 points possible in the entire tournament. You can get 32 points in round 1, and then each game in round 2 counts for 2 points, so there's another 32 points there. In round 3, you have 8 games times 3 points for 24, and so on. And so basically we can know that one of the teams you chose to go deep into the tournament has already lost, and you can't possibly get those points. So here in the early rounds, we're looking at the total points that someone has, but we're also interested in their possible. The possible is what would happen if they won the rest of the games throughout the tournament. Now here at the top, we had a couple of people that went 14-2 on Thursday of last year, but as we scroll down, we start to see some people who already have lost games in round 2 and round 3. That means that their selection to make it to the Elite 8 was already knocked out in round 1. Here's someone where one of their teams in the Final 4 is already out. And you can see they can only have 100 points possible instead of 120. So even though they've only lost 6 games so far, losing 6 points, we know that they've already lost all those future points. So as you're watching the results, you'll be able to see the total score, but more importantly, the possible score. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you tomorrow on Friday, where we'll actually have the first results, and we'll take a look at how we're able to produce this as an HTML page and publish it to the web.